very much. Bangladesh is next.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. I, on behalf of Bangladesh delegation, I would like to take this opportunity to thank the Mexican government for hosting this excellent meeting. Due to time constraint, I will be very brief and would like to emphasize the Bangladesh government's commitment towards safe, orderly, and regular migration. Our government, and especially our Honorable Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina, have taken a number of positive initiatives. For example, enactment of Migration Act 2013, Migration Policy 2016, and Skill Development Policy, NRV Bank, and Migrants Welfare Bank. We have made important migration services more accessible at local level. Our newly formed National Parliamentary Caucus on Migration and Development conducted 10 multi-stakeholders consultations and public hearing at national and regional levels to gather evidence for making necessary reforms in the migration sector. I strongly believe that parliamentarians can play an important overseeing role for implementation of the Global Compact. I would like to emphasize three critical issues for your consideration in the Global Compact. Issue one, ethical recruitment, including reducing the high cost of migration and regulation, the role of middlemen. We understand that it is important to work collectively with sending countries, countries of transit and receiving countries. We found that many aspiring migrants are subject to exploitation, and this exploitation cannot be eradicated without regulation, without regulating the middlemen at both ends. During the consultation and public hearing organized by our parliamentary caucus, we found that middlemen play an important role in the different stages of migration cycle. They are neither recognized nor regulated in any legal instrument at national or international levels. We are bringing people together to find out how this group can be better regulated. I believe that the state parties, especially the receiving countries, should consider how this process can be regulated in their countries. I am happy to know from Bahrain delegate that they have introduced a system to recruit migrants without host sponsorship. This example can be replicated by other countries as well. We also found a huge lack of transparency in the labor recruitment process in sending and receiving countries. Most often recruiters don't follow ethical process, and this causes high cost and ultimately leaves migrants in vulnerable situation. Our recommendation is that countries should follow ethical process in recruitment and abide by global labor standards. Issue two, protection of women migrants. Honorable Chair, I would like to emphasize the pressing issues related to women migrants' human rights, safety and security. We found that many of them experience sexual, mental and physical abuse and exploitation. Sometimes their employers seize their passport so that they are bound to serve in unpleasant environments. Our consultation brought out many causes of denial of assistance of responsible authorities and denial of access to justice. There should be a strong commitment to legally binding mechanism that ensured protection of female workers and compliance in receiving countries with international labor standard. In addition to that, both labor sending and receiving countries should have obligatory and comprehensive bilateral agreements to protect migrants' rights. issue 3, social protection for all migrants and their family members. We stress that the GCM should call for strengthening national social protection system so that migrants have access to justice, information and basic services like health care and education. Such protection is particularly important for those migrants who are in vulnerable situation. I thank you, Mr. Chair and panels and all participants for your patience to hear my statement. Thank you all.
Thank you very much, sir. And next.